Welcome students. Today we are going to see division. So there are some of the questions, and after this we will be doing few more questions, and let's see how to divide two numbers. First we'll be dividing whole number by whole number, then whole number by a decimal number, a decimal by whole, and similarly decimal by decimal. Let's start with the first one. Our objective is to reach to the decimal one. 208 divided by 5. The first part is easy. Since 2 is not divisible, so we'll take both the numbers, 20. So it's 4 times 20. We'll subtract 0, take down 8. So if I take 1, 5, so 3. Now 3 is not divisible by 5. To make it divisible or to divide further, we have to put a decimal. So I'm allowed to use 10 at one place. So 5 times 5, 6, 30. So moving on to the next part. 4 times 1 is 4, 0. Now 1. Now 1 is not divisible by 4. But remember, we cannot take another number at this place. If we are taking another number, we have to put 0. Let me just tell you the logic behind this, why we are taking 0 at that place. Since 1 is not divisible, that means I cannot take the minimum number 1, but less than 1 is 0. So 4 times 0 is 0. So you have to divide this number. So I will be getting 1 as the remainder. Now I am allowed to take down this 7. So 4 times 4 is 16. I'll be getting 1. Now 1 is not divisible, so I'm allowed to take decimal. 0. So 2, 8, 2. Now we have already taken decimals. I'm allowed to take 0 once more. 5, 20. Here it is. So our answer is 104.25. Let us start with our third question, that is 7 upon 3.5. In these kind of questions, I like to do it like this. 7 divided by 3.5. Whenever there is a decimal number in case of division. So I would like to make it in fraction. So 7 upon 1 divided by 35 upon 10. Since this is the 10th place, so 10. So we know that in case of division of fractions, we do right side reciprocal. I call it RR rule. Right reciprocal. So the number is on the right side, will get reciprocal. So 7 upon 1 times 10 upon 35. Now in this case, instead of doing the multiplication, I like to do cancellation. So since 7 and 35 both are in the same table of 7, so 7 times 1, 7 times 5. So 7 times 5 is 35. And 5 times 1 and 5 times 2. So 2 into 1, 2, 1 into 1, 1. If I write in the denominator as 1, it will still be 2. So our answer is 2. By logic also answer is 2. 3.5 times 2 is 7. But the objective of this question is to show the method, because not always you will be getting a direct number. Let us move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is 14.49 divided by 7. So again 14.49, and the 9 is at the 100th place, so I will be writing at 100. And it is divided by 7 upon 1, 1449 upon 100 times 1 upon 7. Now this and this number are divisible. So 7 times 1, 2, it should be 07. How do I get to know? Let me just show you once again, 1449. So I'm dividing it by 7. So 7 times 2 is 14. Now I'm dividing 4. Since 4 is not divisible, so I'll be taking 0, and this 4 will get attached to 9, it will become 49. So 7 times 7 becomes 49. So don't forget to take this 0. Most of the students will say 27. So I'll be writing 207 times 1 is 207 upon 100 times 1 is 100. So answer is 2.07. Fifth question, similarly I'll be writing 3094 upon 100 divided by 7 upon 10. Always write this way, it helps me. So you can also try. If you can do it directly, that is also fine. Times 10 upon 7. So 00 get cancelled, and I'll be dividing these two numbers. Let me just check whether it is divisible. 7 times 3, 7 times 4 is 28. So I'll be getting 29 over here. Again, 7 times 4, 28. I'll be getting 1 over here, 14, 7 times 2. So that's how I get cancelled. It gets cancelled. So I'll be showing once again 3094 divided by 7. So 7 times 1, 30. 7 times 4, 28. So 2 is remainder. Write 2 over here. It becomes 29. So 29 again gets divisible by 7 at 4. It becomes 28. So 1 is remainder. It becomes 14. So 7 times 2, 14. So 442. And this gets cancelled. So we have 442 upon 10. So answer is 44.2. Moving on to our last question. So again, 230, 45 upon 100 divided by 505 upon 10. Right one gets reciprocal, 23045 upon 100 times 10 upon 505. 0, 0 get cancelled. This is ending at 5. This is also ending with 5. So I know they both are getting divisible by 5. So 101, and here I'll be getting 4 times 20. So it becomes 30. So 30 is 6. Now 4 is not divisible. So 0. So 45 is 9. So I'll be getting 4609 upon 10 into 101. So let's keep this 10 as it is, because it will help us in dividing it easily by putting a decimal or moving the decimal to the left hand side. Let us divide these two numbers. So 4609 divisible by 101. So 101, there are 3 digits, so let's divide 3 digits. So 460, that means divisible by 4, 404. I'll be getting 6, 56. Now I'll take down this 9. So this is in 500, so I'll divide it by 5. So 505, it becomes 4, 64. Now 64 is not divisible by 101, so I'll put a decimal. 640, so I'll be taking 6, 606. So whatever is the remainder, it is not completely divisible, but I got a number in decimal. And I know the denominator is still 10. So I'll be getting 45.6 upon 10. So when I divide a decimal with a 10, the decimal gets moved to the left hand side. I'll be getting 4.56 approximate answer. This is not an exact answer, because it is still keeps on divisible. Like, it is not terminated. That means the remainder is not 0. So this is an approximate answer, so we can say, okay, we can say equals to for now, but it is not an exact answer. It is 4.56, something else is still going on. So this is just to give an idea how to divide a decimal number with a decimal number. And we'll be continuing this process in the class. So thank you for watching.